Hey, what's up, everybody? Russ with RWG Research here, and I'm trying this these new pair of glasses that my good buddy Reagan got because he got tired of seeing me hold the camera, so I got these glasses. So we're going to see how these work out. Can you guys see that? Oh, yeah, that's perfect. Now, what I wanted to show you guys, I want to see how the quality of this thing is. So I want to show you guys this resonant cavity that I'm building. This is something you could build on your own. This is a half inch piece of stainless. It's been drilled out on the ends and also through the centers here so that you can have a port in here and out here. This is a piece of 3/4 inch stainless, and this one I chucked in the lathe and got it all bent up. Trying something didn't work out, but that's okay. And here I have two insulators that I lathed down to fit just right. So basically you'll put these together like this. Okay, you see how those fit together? Again, I don't know how well this video is going to turn out because I'm recording this with my new video camera glasses here. So, Reagan, you're awesome, buddy. I finally get to use both hands. Okay, so that fits together like that. So you have this cavity right down here, and you have an inlet port, okay, and an exit port. So we're going to put this together. And push those together with my legs there. And there you go. This will probably need a little glue here and here, especially this side because this is bent up. I might be able to lathe something out and put an O-ring in there on the edge. But basically, this fits right inside this tube. And once I get it in here, I probably won't be able to get it out. Boop. Okay. Just like that. Ah, man, that is in there too. And basically, I'll have a drilled hole here, which goes into the bottom stainless. And I'll have a nut, or a bolt, excuse me, threaded down in there. And also another one that goes to the top side here. My connections will be in the outside. And then I'm also going to build a base plastic piece and a top plastic piece so this can be pressurized. This is actually, this plastic, what this plastic is, it's come off of a fluorescent light bulb. It's a cover for a fluorescent light bulb. It's really, really thin stuff, as you can see here. But that's basically what I am showing you, and something you might be able to kind of make on your own. Let's see if I can push this back out of here. This might not work out well. There we go. Perfect. So that is my new test chamber. I have a much better drawn up full-blown version of this, but this is basically something I could do right now without having some other machined parts being made. And I don't know if many of you have access to a lathe, but these blocks is a, I'm pretty sure this is a Derlin plastic, a high voltage insulator type plastic. This is the stuff that my buddy gave me. Same thing I had in my gas gun here. The insulators here and here. I did order some red LEDs, 10 millimeters. Some really big ones for that thing. And yeah, so I just wanted to give you a quick little update and try out this video camera. And I'm going to make a little tribute to Reagan from these, and show you guys some other stuff that Reagan built for me for other stuff I've been working on. So, peace out, everybody. We'll see how this quality is. You guys let me know what you think. Can't really complain too much. I got both hands. All right, peace, everybody. See if I can bring out, shut this thing off.